Hej, wracamy do Fentona Paddocka. Po ciekawym i jednym z moich ulubionych rozdziałów rozgrywających się w Wewelsburgu trafiliśmy gdzieś do wioski w Indiach bodaj. No i ten rozdział jest trochę spokojniejszy, nie jest aż tak dla mnie emocjonujący i ciekawy jak poprzedni, no ale... ale na pewno przybliży nas do rozwiązania całej intrygi. Tutaj będzie dużo przeszukiwania w tej wiosce, w tej pierwszej lokacji, wyglądającej niemal na wymarłą, bo są domki, ale nikt nie wyściubi nosa nawet ze środka. Pozbierajmy przedmioty, które tutaj się walają. Czyli tak, mamy wiązkę trzciny, którą od razu włożymy do paleniska i za chwilę weźmiemy rezerwową trzcinę. No właśnie, przyda się na podpałkę, ale od razu uzupełniamy zapasy trzciny. No i w zasadzie zbieramy wszystko, co tutaj widać, czyli bambusową rurkę, pióra kurczaka i inne dobrodziejstwa, które nam zaraz będą spływać do inwentarza. Tu jest naprawdę istny raj dla takiego typowego przygodówkowego maniaka, bo przedmioty w ekwipunku to wiadomo cecha charakterystyczna gier przygodowych. No i proszę, pojedynczy ekran gry, pojedyncza lokacja i ile przedmiotów? 7, w tym jeden jeszcze dwukrotnie zabieraliśmy. No i teraz jeszcze może rzućmy okiem na białe futro. Ja widzę, że to jest żywe zwierzę, chyba kuska. Natomiast autorzy nazwali to białym futrem. No nieładnie.
What is that? It's a small goat. It appears to be hiding underneath the hut. Well, no, it's definitely hiding underneath the hut. I can see it from here.
Fenton jest spragniony towarzystwa jakiegokolwiek, więc pewnie będzie próbował za chwilę wyciągać kuskę spod domku. Ale najpierw rozejrzyjmy się jeszcze, sprawdźmy plamy krwi. Skąd się tu wzięły?
Feathers, blood. It's clear what happened here. Some huge winged monster had a nosebleed. Or a chicken got eaten. One of the two.
Ta pierwsza ewentualność zakładałaby chyba, że przylatywał nad wioską smok, bo te plamy są bardzo obfite.
It's dried up in the heat.
Generalnie wioska wygląda bardzo ładnie, szkoda tylko, że jest jakaś taka pusta, jeśli chodzi o ludzką obecność, bo tych domków, no widzimy 5, pewnie jest też ich trochę po drugiej stronie, a tak jak już powiedziałem, nikogo na zewnątrz nie idzie spotkać poza kuską, więc opuśćmy wioskę i skierujmy się tam gdzieś w stronę dżungli.
I'll just take a short wander into the jungle. Maybe the villagers are out foraging or whatever it is villagers do.
Hey, you there! Where do you think you are going?
Christ! You frightened the life out of me! What the hell are you doing hiding in there?
Get away from the edge of the jungle! Come here!
What's wrong?
Don't ask, just do what I say.
Have I done something wrong? Sorry, I didn't mean to sneak around. I just wasn't sure where everyone had got to.
There's a man-eater about.
A what?
Doesn't anything strike you as strange around here?
Well, yes.
He came into the village last night while we were sleeping.
Who?
The man-eater. Listen to me. The beast is still out there. I can feel it in my bones.
And you're the only survivor?
No, during these months only women, children and old people live in the village. The young men work on the tea plantations. When he came, there was no one here to protect us. Those who could walk packed their things and left this morning.
What sort of animal are we talking about here? I'm something of an expert.
A tiger, what else?
A tiger?
It was no normal tiger, it was a man-eater. Tigers normally avoid settlements, they hunt in the jungle. But now and again, a few of the particularly hungry ones stray into the villages. I remember the old stories from my childhood. When a man-eater has picked out a village, he stalks it for days until he can strike again.
When you put it like that, it does sound kind of scary. But I have a very important task, and I'm looking for someone who can help me.
What brings you here, stranger?
I'm looking for an old monastery, or a temple. Do you know anywhere around here that fits the description?
As a matter of fact, there is an old temple nearby.
Great. How do I get there? Could you show me?
You may have no instinct for survival, stranger, but I wish to retain what is left of my life. I cannot leave the village until the man-eater is dealt with.
Okay. Tell you what. I'll have a look around and think of something. If I deal with the tiger, will you lead me to the temple?
Take my word for it, stranger.
Great. It's a deal.
Be careful out there.
Czyli wyjaśniła się sprawa pustej wioski. Po prostu tygrys ludojad wystraszył okolicznych mieszkańców i pozostał tutaj chyba tylko jeden chłop. Ewentualnie może ktoś się jeszcze ukrywa w którymś z domków. No i trochę może brakować na tym etapie gry ludzkiej obecności i rozmów, z tego względu, że w Ewelsburgu rozdział mi się bardzo podobał, ale rozmawialiśmy tylko z jedną osobą. Tutaj też wygląda na to, że tylko jest jeden chłop, z którym możemy pogadać, więc Fenton może się powoli zaczynać czuć samotny. No dobra, czyli tam jest tygrys, no ale my jesteśmy odważni, więc opuszczamy wioskę.
There's thick jungle in every direction. Save for a small trail leading southwest.
Gdzie tutaj się można udać? Tu jest dżungla, może tu?
It looks pretty impenetrable. I'd need a guide to find my way through. I think I'll stay on the path for the time being.
Swoją drogą, tak patrząc na mapę, bardzo fajna okolica. Rzeka, mnóstwo drzew, las. No i tutaj taka plaża. Ciekawe miejsce do zamieszkania. Można pobyć w odosobnieniu sporo czasu. Chociaż też pewnie niebezpieczna. Mamy przykład tygrysa, więc rzeczywiście jest tu niebezpiecznie.
I'll follow the path leading out of the village so I don't get lost. Let's see where it leads to. What is that sound? Christ, there really is a tiger out there. I never knew they sounded like that. Thinking about it, I'm not a vet, but this guy might be injured. No doubt he'd still eat me given half a chance. I should stay out of his way.
Nie wiem, czy jest ranny, na pewno lubi kąpiele. Widać, że stoi w miejscu i tak lekko się unosi i opada. Unosi, opada to jego cielsko. Tygrysy są fajne. No i tak, fajne są tutaj też sympatyczne odgłosy przyrody. Może trochę mogłyby być ciut głośniejsze. No ale generalnie słychać tutaj tę przyrodę, słychać też tygrysa, jakieś ptaki. Także sympatyczna miejscówka. No i mamy też samolot.
I've seen a worryingly large number of plane wrecks in the last week. At least this one wasn't my fault. As far as I know.
Kto wie. Tak, normalnie pewnie by się Fenton próbował teraz dostać do samolotu, ale w obecności tygrysa po prostu nie wypada. Dlatego zbierzmy, co możemy zebrać i zwiewajmy do wioski.
I don't know anything about mushrooms, but that's no reason not to pick them. If they taste foul, I can just throw them away.
Tak, postawa godna dobrego bohatera przygodówki. Nie zna się na czymś, nie wie po co mu to będzie potrzebne, ale ładuje do kieszeni. Trzeba to chwalić.
That's the man-eating tiger I'm supposed to be dealing with. It sounds like it's in pain. Cats. Bloody things have been following me around ever since Hong Kong. They just keep getting bigger. But seriously, what am I going to do once I've got his attention? Other than feed him my innards.
Ojej, tak źle się wypowiadać o kotach? Masz u mnie minusa, Fenton. Dobra, wracajmy do wioski. No i teraz zrobimy jeszcze taką jedną rzecz, mianowicie przetniemy kawałkami garnka koszyk.
The basket's already broken, so I might as well finish cutting it up. I've dismembered the entire thing. All that's left are these thin sticks of wood and the hemp stitching. Oh,
and these two black stones that were inside.
Właśnie, dwa czarne kamienie, chociaż one tutaj nie wyglądają wcale na czarne. Może coś źle przeczytałem. Przyjrzyjmy się im.
Two smooth, sparkling stones. They look rather valuable.
Może cenne. I teraz jeszcze raz porozmawiajmy z tym tubylcem.
Hello?
Yes? Any luck in hunting the tiger?
Yes, I saw the tiger. You're right. He's still lurking about.
Told you so.
I think I know why it came into the village last night as well. He looks injured. He's out in the swamp making sad noises. Would that explain why he's acting so aggressively?
Quite possibly. But regardless, I am staying in my hut. And don't go getting any wild ideas yourself.
But I promise to help.
As you please. Is there anything else?
Is there any chance I can convince you to come out for just 10 minutes? The tiger's out in the swamps. I don't think he really poses a threat.
I forgot I was the tourist and you were the local.
Believe me, it poses a threat.
All right, all right. I'm on it. I found these mushrooms in the jungle. Are they edible?
I would only eat them if you have sleeping problems. These mushrooms contain a natural sedative. We use them to treat minor injuries. But I have heard of a Brahmin who performs operations on injured animals and sedates them with the poison from these mushrooms during the operations.
Interesting. So you just chuck them down the creature's throat?
No, the sedative must get into the bloodstream. The mushrooms are cooked and the juice that escapes is then injected. It requires a bit of experience to get the dosage right. Too much of the stuff could knock out a huge water buffalo. Never mind a small pet.
No problem. Caution is my middle name.
Czyli już wiemy, jak sobie poradzić z tygrysem. Mamy gotową podpowiedź. Chyba z kózką mimo wszystko spróbujemy innego sposobu.
I found these stones in the village square. I don't suppose they're, valuable by any chance?
No. These are flint stones. Keep them by all means.
Oh. Well, thanks anyway. I'll see what I can do.
Good luck.
Krzemienie, więc przy pomocy krzemieni będzie można prawdopodobnie rozpalić ogień. Ale najpierw jeszcze włóżmy te grzybki halucynogenne, usypiające są.
The old man said that you can extract a natural sedative from these mushrooms by boiling them.
Chyba, że się ma halucynacje podczas snu. To może i rzeczywiście są też halucynogenne.
In you go.
Tak, umieszczamy je w dzbanku i będziemy robili wywar, ale najpierw rozpalmy ogień.
The reeds caught. The logs shouldn't be far behind.
No już się zapaliło. Tak, i teraz stawiamy ten dzbanek na palenisku.
If the old guy is telling the truth, I can boil these mushrooms into some kind of natural sedative. That was quick. There's a dark sap oozing out.
No i teraz trzeba będzie zdjąć dzbanek z paleniska. Można to zrobić na dwa sposoby. To jest ciekawe i cenne. Albo szmatką, albo... Nie wiem, zobaczę, patyczkami, czy bambusową tyczką. Bambusową tyczką. Więc spróbujemy tego drugiego sposobu.
I should be able to hook the jug without burning my fingers.
Szmata by się mogła zapalić, więc... Ten sposób mi się wydał ciut bezpieczniejszy. Dobra, mamy już dzbanek ze środkiem usypiającym. Może zanim jeszcze sporządzimy jakieś te strzałki do polowania na tygrysa. Nie do polowania, tylko do usypiania tygrysa. To spróbujmy może kózkę stąd wywabić jakoś, pokazując jej zioła.
He looks hungry. Goats eat green things, don't they? Okay, little guy. Fancy an adventure?
Czyli zdaje się, że to jest jednak pan koziołek. Nie wiem, mała koza czy kozioł.
It's a goat. There's a goat in my pocket. Don't ask me how
Or more pertinently, why?
Tłumacze się nie mogą zdecydować, bo raz rodzaj żeński, raz rodzaj męski stosują. Dobra, opuszczamy wioskę. Nie wiem, ja bym tego nigdy nie zrobił, ale Fenton będzie próbował nakarmić tygrysa kuską.
He does look hungry. What am I saying? I couldn't do that to my only friend. Borrowing from the gods, teasing sheep, stealing just about anything I can lay my hands on. Fine. But I am not going to feed this goat to a tiger. Now, bait? That's an entirely different issue. Might be I can use him as some kind of decoy.
Narazi biedne zwierzątko na taki stres, no ale dobrze, że przynajmniej nie nakarmił tygrysa kozą. Tak bym mu nie wybaczył nigdy.
It's a goat. There's a goat in my pocket. Don't ask me how, or more pertinently, why.
A, chyba już słyszeliśmy ten tekst, ale nie zaszkodzi go usłyszeć po raz drugi. Teraz będzie trzeba tę naszą strzałkę zmontować. I tak, jest potrzebne kilka rzeczy do tego. Przede wszystkim nasze drewniane patyczki łączymy z piórami i z kawałkami garnka powinniśmy je połączyć. Jeszcze raz pójdę do wioski i spróbuję to tutaj zrobić. Czyli trzeba to zrobić w odpowiedniej kolejności. Kawałki garnka najpierw połączyć z patyczkami.
I can tie one of the pottery shards to one of the sticks.
I dopiero później pióra z kurczaka na to włożyć.
Great. I'll use a few fibers from the hemp cord to make fletching for the dart. I could probably manufacture an operational blowgun. The dart looks like it'll fly straight, but I'm missing one little thing.
Czego jeszcze brakuje? Brakuje bambusowej tyczki. Będziemy mieli już gotową broń.
I could probably manufacture an operational blowgun. The dart looks like it'll fly straight, but I'm missing one little thing.
Aha, jeszcze czegoś brakuje tutaj. Czego brakuje? Brakuje... Trzeba to namoczyć środkiem usypiającym.
I'll dip the tip in the homemade tranquilizer.
No tak. Czasem przydaje się też trochę myślenia w przygodówkach, a nie automatyczne wykonywanie czynności nie jest dobre.
Voila! A perfect tranquilizer.
Nie, póki koza jest w naszym ekwipunku, to nie będziemy usypiać tygrysa. Przywiążemy kuskę do drzewa najpierw. Będzie naszą przynętą.
I'll tie a piece of the cord around the goat's neck, so it doesn't run off before I'm done with it.
W tych warunkach w wiosce łatwiej będzie tygrysa trafić.
I'll tie him up here. I hope this works.
Meh.
Don't worry, you're not bait. You're just a distraction.
Tak, jasne, nie jesteś przynętą. Szkoda mi trochę tej kuski, no ale poświęca się dla dobra sprawy. Ratuje świat.
Okay, preparations are in place. I'll lure the tiger into the village, then hide behind the tree in the square. While the tiger's busy with the goat, I should have just enough time to hit him with the dart. Let's hope the sedative works. For my sake, as well as the goat's. Do or die.
Ale się trzęsie, biedna kuska.
Only one shot at this. Concentrate.
Have you shot it?
No, I've just sedated it.
Sedated? And what happens when it wakes up?
Look, he's injured. There's a nail stuck in his front paw.
Ah, you are correct. He has obviously fallen into a trap.
You set up traps to piss these guys off?
No, no. Many farmers in this area protect their fields and plantations from all sorts of animals with spike traps such as these. If a tiger gets injured by such a trap, it cannot hunt in its usual way.
And it gets angry.
It begins to look for easier prey.
Chickens, goats, people.
Exactly.
Okay, let's pull the nail out. Then we can take him out into the jungle and hopefully he'll wake up and wander back to his natural habitat.
This could work. I extend my thanks and the thanks of the entire village to you, stranger.
You know, thanks are great and all, but don't forget our deal. Let me take a look at this guy's foot. You find something we can use to move him.
Okay. I'll fetch a cart, and we can take it to the other side of the valley.
Okay, we're done.
Then I will lead you to the old temple, as promised. Follow me. This is it.
Here? But I don't see a temple.
Behind me, in the lagoon.
What do you mean, in the lagoon?
According to records, there was a narrow valley here in which a temple stood until a few hundred years ago. One day, after a heavy storm, the valley was flooded along with the temple. Since this day, everything that remains of the temple is under the surface of the water. Only this statue standing on the roof of the temple bears witness to what lies beneath.
Do you think anything's still intact down there?
I cannot swim. How would I know?
Okay. Well, thanks for your help.
It was no problem, stranger. I had better make my way to the next village to tell the women that the tiger is no longer a danger. Would you care to accompany me?
Women, you say? No, I really ought to get back to saving the world. Thank you, though.
As you wish. Good luck.
I usually need it.
Pierwszy problem za nami, drugi przed. Ten drugi problem to dostanie się do tej świątyni. Posąg iście imponujący znajduje się na dachu tejże świątyni.
This statue is all that's left to be seen of the temple. The rest disappeared underwater when the lagoon formed.
Skaczemy pod wodę, sprawdźmy, czy jest tam jakieś wejście.
Perhaps some of the temple's still intact. I've got to check it out. At least the water's nice and warm. You know, it all started innocently enough. Flies. Nothing dangerous about flies. Then there was the cat. Then the sheep. The tiger. Now sharks. Bloody sharks. I'd better steer clear of him. At least the temple looks intact. I'd better head back to the shore before he spots me. Okay. I have to get rid of that shark if I'm going to reach the temple.
Wygląda na to, że Fenton nie ma szczęścia do zwierząt.
I'll fill it with water.
Wracamy teraz na bagna. Ponieważ nie ma już tutaj tygrysa, możemy z powodzeniem wspiąć się do wraku samolotu.
Let's get up there and take a look.
No i sprawdzimy, co znajduje się w środku. Czy jest tam coś ciekawego w ogóle?
This wreck's old. The jungle's begun eating into it. There's a cardboard box in relatively good condition in the glove compartment. But everything else is foobar. Let's see what's in this box. Looks like an old radio.
Stare radio może pomóc nam się z kimś skontaktować, jeśli zostaniemy sami tutaj w dziczy.
A radio with a hand-operated generator. You produce power by turning this little crank on the side. Oh, it fell off.
Chyba jest jednak niesprawne. Spójrzmy jeszcze na tę pokrywę, albo spróbujmy ją otworzyć.
The cover is attached with four hexagonal nuts. I need something to unscrew them.
No, czyli dobrze się jednak składa, że korba odpadła. Może nam się tutaj przyda.
Wow, blind luck. The radio crank fits right into the bolts on the cover. Ah, there's an electrics cable under here. Might come in handy.
No dobra, i to już chyba wszystko, co w tym miejscu trzeba było zrobić. Więc żegnamy chyba na dobre tę lokację, chociaż nie, jeszcze tutaj wrócimy, przepraszam. Jeszcze tutaj na chwilę przynajmniej wrócimy, jeszcze tu będziemy. Dobra, skoro już mamy te najważniejsze rzeczy stąd, przynajmniej na tę chwilę, to wracamy nie do laguny, nie tutaj, lecz do wioski. Polewamy wodą plamy krwi, bo teraz szykujemy jakąś przynętę dla rekina. I moczymy szmatę w krwi.
I've soaked the cloth in the blood. There are certain things I like carrying around with me. Matches, booze, women. Old muddy bloodstained rags are not one of those things.
Zapałki gorzała kobiety. Ciekawe upodobania. Nie powiedziałbym, że jakieś nietypowe. Raczej Fenton należy do takich typowych facetów. Nie wiem, czy to komplement, czy nie. Nie mnie oceniać. No dobra, teraz szmatę podłączamy do... nic, do kabla.
I'll tie the rag to one end of the cable.
Kabel z kolei do radia.
I'll connect one end of the cable to the contacts on the radio.
No i podłączymy to, zainstalujemy tę...
The radio can be charged electrically. And that charge could then be conducted down the cable. Sharks, I'm sure, are sensitive beings at heart. Even a small shock should be enough for him to turn tail. Of course, he's right on the lagoon bed. I'll need him to be right on top of the cable for it to work. Hopefully the smell of blood will be enough to attract his attention. It's working. The shark surfaced and he's circling the bait. I need to hurry before he pulls the whole thing under.
Tak, podłączyliśmy tutaj tę maszynerię i teraz pokręćmy korbą, żeby jakoś porazić rekina.
Whap! 40 volts straight to the face. Fenton Paddock, top of the food chain. Time to get down there and check out this temple.
Chyba mu się nie spodobało, odpłynął. Możemy już swobodnie nurkować, ale tutaj będzie taka drobna czasówka. Mamy powietrza ograniczoną ilość, więc szybko trzeba nasze sprawy załatwić. Zabieramy ten pręt, który się znajduje na dnie. Jest tu też jakaś ziemia czy muł.
I'll collect some mud.
Jeszcze może sprawdźmy te drzwi.
It's a huge gate with a recess in the center. A jagged indentation. The recess isn't very big. I can reach all the way in. There seems to be some kind of mechanism back here.
Dobra, wiemy już to, co najważniejsze. Wypływamy, zanim Fenton nam się udusi.
I have my strengths, but breathing underwater isn't one of them.
To niestety przydałyby się czasem skrzela. Prętem pozbywamy się roślin. Z tego czegoś, bo nie wiem, co to jest, ale... te rośliny porastają w jakiś posąg, czy cokolwiek.
There. I've managed to cut away the plants with the sharp edge of the pole.
Szybko, takim jednym zamachem się pozbył tych roślin z kolumny. Zbadajmy ją.
There's a small carving here.
No dobra, teraz powiedziałem, że jeszcze powrócimy na bagna i to jest ta chwila właśnie. Prętem nacinamy lianę.
I severed the vine. It's dripping some kind of oily sap. There's oily plant sap dripping from where I severed it.
Oleista substancja. Nie. Moczymy w niej wiązkę trzciny.
I'll soak the reeds with some of the sap.
No, ja chciałem nabrać substancji do tego dzbanka, ale Fenton miał inne zdanie. Nie będę się z nim kłócił przecież. Dobra, no i skoro teraz już mamy to, co mamy, to wracamy tutaj do laguny. I co teraz możemy zrobić? Możemy zamoczyć to pudło w wodzie. Będziemy próbowali jakoś sforsować ten zamek.
The cardboard softened in the water.
No a teraz tej trzciny użyjmy na rzeźbie.
If it's good for my skin, it can't do any harm to an old rock. I'll oil it up. Perfect. This should make for a good mold. The damp cardboard will dry around the carving, and the plant oil should let me get it off again in one piece.
Czyli do tego otworu w drzwiach będziemy chcieli to włożyć. Jeszcze dzbanek do tego? Nie, zabieramy.
The cardboard's dried in the heat. If I just remove it carefully, and yes, a beautiful cardboard mold. I filled the cardboard mold with clay.
No i tak, mamy już prawie wszystko, ale trzeba jakoś utrwalić tę formę. No i w tym celu po prostu ją wypalimy w ogniu.
Let's hope it's hot enough to fire the clay. That should do it. The cardboard's burned away, and the clay looks pretty solid.
Zabieramy to, co otrzymaliśmy metalowym prętem, no i wracamy do laguny. I teraz sprawdzimy, czy ten odlew będzie pasował do tej wnęki w drzwiach. Oczywiście kształt tej wnęki w drzwiach jest identyczny jak tego wyżłobienia na posągu. No i ruszajmy. Powietrza mamy pod dostatkiem w płucach. Wystarczy go nam z pewnością. Tylko czy ten pomysł zadziała?
It fits. We're in business. How has no water reached this part of the temple? It smells old and dank. But at least I can breathe.
Przyznam, że pomieszczenie całkiem fajnie wygląda. Przede wszystkim byłoby chyba gratką dla miłośników urban exploringu, tak to się nazywa, czyli łażenia po jakichś opuszczonych miejscach. Świetne, klimatyczne, mnóstwo takich fajnych, fajnie wyglądających fresków. W ogóle cała architektura tego miejsca jest świetna, fajnie wygląda. Do tego ta woda tutaj. Naprawdę świetne miejsce. Najpierw zbierzmy stąd kamienie. Jest ich 6. 3 są tutaj dookoła tego jakiegoś okręgu. Nie wiem, co to jest. I teraz na tych freskach znajdują się też 3 kamienie.
There's a round stone jutting out of the wall here. I'll grab it.
3 freski, na każdym z nich jest jeden
There's
kamień.
A loose stone protruding slightly from this painting.
No i później jeszcze przyjrzymy się tym freskom, bo naprawdę jest co podziwiać.
And another stone.
Mam już 6 kamieni, tyle jest nam dokładnie potrzebnych.
The painting shows burning houses. and many, many dead people. They're fighting one another on a huge mountain of corpses. But they don't look like warriors. They're just townsfolk, murdering one another. Is this the fall of Shambhala? The inexplicable catastrophe that Professor Hayes mentioned, but he said it was a dragon, and Kim translated something similar back at the monastery. These people are killing each other. But why?
Freski są mocno niepokojące.
The painting up there has a number of people reaching the shores of a sea or a river by boat. These must be the Shambhala survivors, the ones who came here to hide the second key. That can't be. That looks like a British Army uniform. But this place was supposed to have been built millennia ago.
Czyżby, nie wiem, osoby, które zbudowały te świątynie, w jakiś sposób potrafiły czytać, przewidywać przyszłość?
The same characters as the monastery in Tibet. This is definitely the right place. It's a magnificent city with some kind of glowing orb in the center. This must be Shambhala, the light at the center. That must be the source of these morphogenetic fields. It's the world soul. It's so well preserved. The painting seems to portray a scene Professor Hayes told me about. It's a group of herdsmen or hunters entering a large cave in the mountains. These are the people who discovered the entrance to Shambhala many thousands of years ago.
Bardzo ciekawe miejsce. Można z niego wyczytać historię Shambhali.
These glass windows must be thick as hell to withstand the water pressure, but this place was supposed to have been built over 10,000 years ago. They should barely have had two sticks to rub together. Christ! All these stories and legends. They're all beginning to feel very real. There's a plinth in the middle of the room.
No dobrze.
Okay. We've got six circular recesses arranged around a symbol. This must be where the artifact was stored all that time ago. I'd better take a closer look.
Poglądaliśmy sobie to miejsce, ale pora na finałową zagadkę.
There's a small slab in the middle of the plinth with a symbol on it.
Trzeba tutaj umieścić naszych sześć kamieni.
It looks like something.
Tak, zgadza się. Coś trzeba włożyć. Widzimy, że każdy kamień przedstawia inny symbol.
I heard something move inside. Is it unlocked?
I teraz kamienie można wciskać.
Aha. The stones can be pushed down into the platform.
Tylko zwróćmy uwagę, że wciśnięcie jednego kamienia wciska też inny. Na przykład tego pierwszego, licząc od godziny 12, powoduje też wciśnięcie piątego z sześciu kamieni. Drugiego też, drugi z kolei wycisnął piąty. Trzeci też piąty. Proszę, czyli każdy z kamieni wciska również, a nie, piąty, a ten szósty kamień, kiedy wcisnęliśmy, wcisnął się również trzeci, bądź wycisnął. No dobra. No to zdaje się, że nie będzie to trudna zagadka.
Finally, the second key. I've traveled three continents just to find this thing. I should be happy. Or at least relieved. But there's something bothering me. Something at the back of my mind. I'm finally holding in my hands the key to Shambhala. The key to rescuing Richard. And I've got this weird feeling about it all. Is that my conscience? Damn, I thought I lost the thing years ago. Maybe all this wasn't such a good idea. How many people have already died for this thing? And how many more will die if I open the gate to Shambhala? Beyond all the myths and the legends, there has to be something real at the end of it all. There is something behind that gate, that shouldn't be messed with. I don't know. Maybe it's this place, or maybe I'm just tired, but I can't help but think back to Hong Kong Harbor. I made a split-second decision to save Richard. And it was the wrong one. I won't make the same mistake again. I don't have the luxury of special circumstances as an excuse this time. And this time, there's a lot more at stake. Kim said you can't weigh one life against another. Last time, my mistake cost 8 lives. This time, it could be thousands. I've got to accept the reality. I can't go back to Tibet. I have to go back to where it all began. I have to justify the most difficult decision of my entire life.
Lord Weston.
Yes?
Mr. Paddock is back.
What? What are you waiting for? Send him in, quickly. Fenton, you have no idea how relieved I am to see you.
Lord Weston.
Do you have any news of my son? Is he alive?
I'm afraid it's not that simple, Governor.
Is Richard dead? Is that what you're trying to tell me?
No, he's still alive, I think.
Oh, thank God. Do you need more money? How can I help you? Just say the word, I'll do everything within my power.
Sir, I know where your son is. I even have the key to the gate that leads to his location. The problem is, I can't be answerable for opening that gate.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Richard is in a place in the Himalayas called Shambhala. For some reason, he fled there when his unit was attacked by Nazi troops. Maybe it was the only way he could prevent the Nazis from entering Shambhala. The point is, that place holds a secret so vital, it cannot be permitted to fall into the wrong hands at any cost. This is what I've come to realize. The second key could undo everything Richard has worked for. If I reopen the gate in order to follow him, I'd risk letting the Nazis into Shambhala. Lord Weston, we have to destroy the second portal key. I'm sorry, but the dangers it represents are simply too great.
What are you saying? You suggest that we leave my son, your friend, to his fate?
Lord Weston, you know what Richard means to me. You know what I've sacrificed for him. Believe me, if there were any other way, I would take it. I know it's hard to accept, but after everything I've seen and experienced, I just can't continue with this mission. I'm here today to ask for your understanding.
I cannot believe I'm hearing this. You sentenced my son to death, and you come here asking for absolution. I was wrong about you, Paddock. If you are unable to handle the situation, I shall have to find someone who is.
As I said, I'm very sorry, Lord Weston. But I've made my decision. I'm going to destroy the key.
I'm afraid that decision is no longer in your hands.
What is this? You're collaborating with the Nazis, Governor!
I had no choice, Fenton. Mr. Kleist claimed to know where Richard was. He said he could return him to me. I was skeptical that a father will cling to even the slightest shred of hope. I never gave up hope that you would solve the situation and that I could quickly end my collaboration with the Nazis. But now I realize that I backed the wrong horse.
Governor, this is a mistake.
I'm prepared to take that risk.
Herr Paddock, I wonder if you would be so kind as to accompany me to the airport. You have an appointment in Tibet that you absolutely cannot miss.
We meet again, Mr. Paddock.
It's a dubious pleasure, Countess. But I guess you've become rather accustomed to having me around.
Had I been given the choice, you would be lying in your wretched Hong Kong shack with a hole between your eyes, believe me. I console myself knowing this will be the last time your good fortune keeps you alive. I hardly imagine you are aware of the fact, but you must at least have felt the transfer of energy when you held the second artifact in your hands, yes? Paddock, you have connected with the key. You are now the only person capable of using it.
You mean you can't get into Shambhala without little old me?
Precisely.
And you think I'm going to help you?
But of course, there can be no doubt.
I hate to break it to you, love, but if I really am your last option, you're rather scraping the bottom of the barrel. Your expedition ends here.
Tut, tut, Mr. Paddock. You are always so hasty to judge before knowing all the facts. I am well aware of the lengths you would go to keep Shambhala from us. You would merrily abandon your greatest friend for that very reason. But I wonder, would you so capriciously condemn to death your pretty little accomplice?
Kim.
You would merrily abandon your greatest friend for that very reason. But I wonder, would you so capriciously condemn to death your pretty little accomplice? Oh, please don't look so dejected. At least you have one less life on your conscience. Well, if you cooperate, that is. Please don't make me describe to you what will happen to your girlfriend should you fail to comply. I think you have the imagination to make the right decision.
Kim, are you okay?
Just about.
Well?
Okay, okay. Let her go and I'll do whatever you want.
I would dearly love to grant you this wish, but alas, it may be that your friend can make herself useful on the other side of the portal. No, she stays with us, but she gets to live a little longer.
Fine. What do you want me to do?
Place the second key in the recess on the pedestal. We will talk some more in Shambhala.
Fenton, wake up!
What?
Fenton!
What? Richard? Richard, is that you?
Of course it's me. Are you feeling okay?
You... Why do you look like a ghost?
Oh, charming. You came all this way just to tell me I've seen better days.
I don't understand. My head hurts.
Apparently your sense of humor is still en route. Well, what is there to say but... Welcome to Shambhala. It was good to see Wang's niece again, but I would have preferred it if you'd left the Nazis on the other side.
Kim! Where is she?
She landed in the central cavern along with the Countess. I managed to convince the guardians of this place to separate you and bring you here instead.
Guardians? You mean there are still people here?
No, not in present-day Shambhala. Just you, Kim, and a few dozen Nazis.
So, what the hell are you talking about then? And what happened to you? Why are you all... flaky?
Ah, well, that's the story, isn't it? When I used the original key back in the monastery, it transported me to Shambhala. But the Shambhala of the past. It seems when the key was constructed thousands of years ago, the monks who stayed in the Kembalung Valley to guard it planned to use it to return here someday. I don't begin to understand how any of this works, but believe me when I say that this place holds extraordinary power.
So I've read. Something about morphogenetic fields.
Providing it a name implies an explanation for something inexplicable, but yes, if you like, morphogenetic fields. The high priests described Shambhala as the heart of the world. But in truth, it's more like the soul. If you want to see it in a scientific light, I suppose you could say that the energy of this place is what constitutes the life force of every living creature throughout time. Just as every single person has a soul that makes him the person that he is, every species has a soul that makes the species what it is. And the sum of all that resides here. The world soul.
Would you be shocked if I said this was all a little over my head?
I've been here for days and I still don't understand it. I don't believe we'll ever understand this place completely. Just take it as fact. There is an energy here. An imperceptible energy that bonds us all.
How imperceptible exactly?
Well, we are all linked to one another subconsciously. But it's true that certain people are able to detect the fields with more precision than others. We call them mediums or oracles. But the energy fields explain a lot more than that. Think about natural instincts, or phenomena such as mass panic. They're all a result of the ebb and flow of those subconscious links.
Well, it all sounds very grand, but what does it actually mean on a practical level? Are we in danger?
Fenton, imagine the heart of Shambhala as a gigantic archive, a pool of everything people have ever researched, discovered, or developed.
So, that's a yes then.
It is. The entire world converges right here.
And the Countess knows that.
But it's not just that. The center transcends time and space. He who controls it controls the sum of all human knowledge, past, present,
and future. They could conquer the world.
No, that's not the threat. The power of this place is too much for any person to control. Mankind doesn't have the maturity to handle this gift. Even the priests of primeval times failed.
So, this field of energy ended up making the residents of Shambhala kill each other in a civil war?
Correct.
How?
Imagine understanding everything, instantly. The spirit of a person would be subjected to extraordinary strain. They simply couldn't cope. Besides, there are darker forces at work. This archive is not limited to discoveries and inventions. It represents the entirety of the human condition. Jealousy, envy, hate, these define the human species just as much as learning or understanding, and have a corresponding influence here in Shambhala. But, as I said before, it is not something we can easily understand.
Okay, fine. So we just wait for the Countess to open the center. I'll dash in, grab Kim, then we sit back and watch while they all kill each other.
You're absolutely right.
But?
In my time, Fenton, the surviving priests are preparing to leave Shambhala for good. In order to protect the heart from misuse, they are performing a ceremony that will set up a force field around it. This field will allow only the bearer of a certain amulet to pass through. After the ceremony, the amulet will be divided into three pieces and hidden in the temples of three priest castes who once ruled here.
Hey, even better. The Nazis won't get past square one.
No. They've begun to plant explosives. The field is maintained in your time by a series of plinths. It would take a great deal of power, but they may be able to destroy them. We have to stop them, Fenton. They may not be able to wield the power of Shambhala, but if the energy of this place is disrupted in any way, it could have catastrophic effects for every living creature on the planet. We must act quickly.
We? I thought you were stuck in the past.
You're right. But you won't find the three amulet pieces without my help. If I understand it correctly, our times are now synchronized. We can communicate, but we cannot cross the boundary. In my time, the priests are only just now performing the ceremony to invoke the force field. So the amulet has not yet been hidden, and I have no way to know where it will be placed. But that doesn't mean to say I can't help you look for it.
And what am I supposed to do with the thing when I find it?
You will have to use the power of the source to drive off the Nazis.
As in the source that sends anyone who goes anywhere near it to Doolally? That source? Is there a plan B?
Don't worry. Once you find the dragon amulet, I will help you control it.
Okay, let's do it.
I couldn't agree more. The future of the world is in our hands.
Serce świata, rozdział 8. Siódmy.
Looks like I'm on my own again. I'm still not sure I've got a handle on all this. 10,000 years ago, the residents of Shambhala all kill each other, save for a few priests who escape the civil war. Shortly after that, Richard crash lands here and convinces those priests to invoke a force field around the center to protect it. Now the Countess, along with her troops, and Kim, are in the center of Shambhala, ready to blow the bloody thing up. And, surprise, surprise, I'm the only one that can stop them. I need three pieces of some amulet to harness the power of the source and somehow make everything okay again. That's Richard's plan, in any case. I'll probably just wander around breaking things until something interesting happens.
Tak, jak widzimy, można się przełączać pomiędzy Richardem a Fentonem. Teraz jesteśmy Fentonem. Krótki był szósty rozdział, ale zakończył się taką bardzo długą serią animacji, bo najpierw nasza wizyta u gubernatora, później w tej komorze, przez którą dostaliśmy się do Shambhali, no i końcowa dyskusja z Richardem, to zajęło sporo czasu, także odcinek będzie długi. No i też sporo się zadziało, jeśli chodzi o fabułę, jeśli chodzi o wyjaśnienie realiów panujących tutaj w tej Shambhali na przestrzeni wieków, bo jest i przeszła Shambhala i teraźniejsza. Trudno to sobie pojąć tak w pierwszej chwili, trzeba nad tym chwilę pomyśleć. No a taka podróż w czasie i towarzystwo Niemców, takie realia wojenne, to mi przypomina trochę, tak skojarzyło mi się w pewnym stopniu z książką Dina Kunca pod tytułem Grom. Czytałem jakieś, nie wiem, 15 lat temu może i wówczas mi się podobała, pewnie kiedyś jeszcze sięgnę po nią ponownie. Tymczasem na tę chwilę to już wszystko, zobaczymy się ponownie w ostatnim rozdziale. Tymczasem do usłyszenia, pa pa.